the music publishing course that I do here, I co-teach with a professor by the name of Ajay Gosain, he's managed nightclubs, he's managed bands, he ran a record label, he's shopping films and TV shows. He's a really great guy, and I think it's very effective for us together to teach this class, because I come very much from the songwriter-centric performing rights world, whereas Ajay is on the other side of that coin, where he makes his money from the songwriters that he works with. So he's very much about how to exploit works, and I'm very much about teaching these kids that they need to retain their rights as much as they can, like hold on to your publishing for as long as you possibly can. Don't just sign it away because somebody puts a contract in front of you. But we also are able to teach the flip side of that coin, where if you were going to become a music publisher, you need to be aggressive and you need to get out there and sign these writers to contracts that are going to be as favorable as possible to you. There are two sides to that equation, and I think we teach them both fairly effectively. But we start from square one. We teach them everything they need to know, from filing a PA or SR copyright form to co-publishing administration, sub-publishing deals, how to acquire or sell catalog, basically the entire world of music publishing. And it's a very abstract and, I think, fairly specialized field that a lot of these kids have a vague knowledge of, but don't really understand the mechanics of it, and we try to simplify it as much as possible. The other class that I teach is the Art and Business of Recording, which is really it's a freshman level class, and it's basically aimed at trying to explain the nature of the music industry to these kids who are just getting in and have these kind of fantastic ideas that are based more on MTV Cribs or whatever they've seen on or read in these kind of unauthorized biographies of rock stars and stuff like that. That number one, there's a huge talent element to it. That there are people, this may just be my own personal feeling, but you kind of have it or you don't, I think, in a lot of cases. There's something ineffable about being this, the guy in the spotlight that you just can't teach somebody. And it's a hard realization to come to that you may not be that guy, but that there are so many other jobs in the business that you can get, and that during your journey towards figuring out whether you are that person or not, whether you're going to be the star, or you're going to be the star's manager, or the star's agent or attorney or whatever, that you're going to make a lot of connections, and you need to take advantage of those things, and don't put all your eggs in one basket. That it's a big industry, and they just need to understand that there's a lot more possibilities out there than either being a star or being a failure.